right, thank you, Angie. Now you can see my man commentating on CNN. He's also a lawyer, very solid guy, and there's a lot going on with this whole Biden town hall that's happening tonight. Once time for our good friend Bakari Sellers.
Man, what's going on? What's going on? I need my own chair in studio. That's what I need. I need my own chair in studio once a week.
Well, the studio is empty, so like you can pick any seat. We're all at the crib right now, so I think we're all in the studio right now. So, Bakari, man, with the Biden town hall happening tonight, what does Vice President Biden need to do tonight with less than 3 weeks left to the election?
Man, so tonight is a closing argument because people have to understand that we're not campaigning anymore. Nobody's in campaign mode anymore. This is all about get out the vote. You see the long lines in Georgia. You see the long lines. Early voting starts today in North Carolina. People have been voting since October 5th. I voted October 5th in South Carolina. So this is about just mobilizing your base, having a sense of urgency, and telling them why they should get out and bring their friends to the voting booth with them. So tonight is a closing argument that has to have some level of urgency, because we're no longer trying to – if you undecided now, there's something wrong with you. This is about getting your voters to the polls.
Makes a lot of sense. Now, Supreme Court nominee Amy Coney Barrett's confirmation hearings are going to be wrapping up today. Now, what is the Biden campaign positioning right now with her confirmation? You know, because it seems like it's going to possibly happen before the election. Can she be stopped?
No, she can't be stopped. I mean, look, my dad would always say that sometimes when you see that light at the end of the tunnel, that's not light. That's a train coming your way. And, you know, it's a train coming. I mean, she's going to be placed on the Supreme Court. I think that the process is illegitimate. I think that the way that she got on the court was because there was a black woman who was supposed to be in her seat that she sits in today, that Mitch McConnell did not allow a hearing on. He froze over 100 of Barack Obama's judges. She is not the most qualified individual, but the fact is she's going to be on the Supreme Court. And that is why these elections matter, because when people say justice is on the ballot, this is what they're talking about. The Supreme Court is so important because the Supreme Court can roll back all of our civil rights and liberties. It can roll back our environmental protections. I mean, literally, they are having discussions about laws that would take us back to the days of Plessy versus Ferguson when we had separate but equal. I mean, this is the seriousness of this matter, which is why I urge everyone to make sure they go out and vote.
Gotcha. For those who just joining us, we're talking to Bakari Sellers. You can catch him on CNN. Now, let's just say, when Biden secures the presidency, because, you know, with a positive energy only, right? He's going to be inheriting a lot of problems that were left behind by the recent administration. You got Dr. Anthony Fauci talking about how families need to cut back this Thanksgiving. This COVID situation is seemingly ramping up to be out of control again. Does Biden have a clear plan once he takes office on how to handle this virus and how to get things back to some level of normalcy?
Well, the answer to the question is yes. I mean, even the best plans, you know, sometimes you got a good plan to go out there and stop Lamar Jackson for the Baltimore Ravens, right? And it's just, you got to be prepared. It's a huge task. So does he have a plan? The answer is yes. But Donald Trump has made such a mess of where we are, and there's so many issues that we have in this country today, that the coronavirus is first and foremost. And I think that plan centers around a national mask mandate. Just think, if everyone wore a mask for a month, we could get back to normal months before they're expecting us to. The reason that this season is going to be so tough is because it's going to be the combination of COVID and the flu. And you imagine somebody getting both of those. I mean, so it's just, it's not just the public health crisis, though. It's the economic crisis that is directly affecting black people, particularly black women and their small businesses. And so, yes, a stimulus package, a relief package that comes out, public health mandates that will come out. I think that is the way that you tackle COVID so we can at least get back to normal.
Okay, now, Bakari Sellers, let's just say someone's sitting in the car today and they just started paying attention this week to the election and the upcoming, you know, everything, right? If you're undecided, why should Joe Biden be your person for president?
Because we have to get back to a sense of normalcy. I think that even if you haven't been paying attention to this political process, you know that something's not right in the world. You know that we're in the middle of a pandemic that didn't have to be this bad. And people are dying, particularly black folk, because of the incompetence of the White House. We know that we have an economy that's spiraling out, that we just got back off of a shutdown, and certain communities are having to shut down again because of that incompetence. And so when you think about the coronavirus, or you just think about getting back to some global stature in the world, or what directly affects your family, I think that we understand that this administration has been a failure and it's time for a change. And so I'm urging everyone to go out and vote and participate in this process, because even if you, I mean, I'm going to be real with you guys, because like I always am, you know, sheriffs are on the ballot if you care about criminal justice. County councils are on the ballot. City councils are on the ballot. DAs are on the ballot. It's not just the president. And while I want everybody to go out and support Joe Biden, I really want everybody to participate in the process, because there's so much on the ballot that directly affects our lives every single day.
Absolutely. Yo, Bakari Sellers, always a wealth of information. Thank you so much. And to add to your last point, there's some parts in the country where, like, the COVID rates are ticking back up to where, like, you know, more states may find themselves in the red, you know, more so than they have been before. So if you can vote early, please do. Just so if it's really, really bad by November 3rd, you know, they don't be like, ah, we'll just take the votes we got already and base it off of that. Get out there and vote early if you can. Bakari Sellers, man, be sure you catch this man on CNN. And if they want to follow you on the gram or social media, where do they go?
Come to Bakari Sellers on Instagram, and Bakari_ Sellers on the Twitter. And pick up the book, My Vanishing Country.
My brother, man, one time for Bakari Sellers.